Welcome to the complete FPS optimization guide for Fortnite on Windows 11. This should be quite an easy tutorial. For more information, click on the first link in the description below. We will first take a look at your in-game settings before making changes to your operating system. Open up Fortnite and navigate to your settings. In the Video tab, make sure to set the window mode to full screen. This will in any case improve your performance. I have set it to windowed as it's easier to record. Below, set the resolution to your native monitor resolution. In case you still have low FPS after applying the next changes, then you should consider lowering the display resolution a bit. This will in any case improve your performance, but the visual quality will suffer a lot. Your frame rate limit should be set to a value above your screen's refresh rate, but below the maximum FPS you can steadily hold. In my case, that would be 160 FPS. In the graphics section, you can change these settings to your personal preference, as these will have no impact on your performance. Under graphics quality, set the quality preset to medium for low to mid NPCs. Below, the 3D resolution option will heavily reduce the visual quality and can make the game look very pixelated when lowered too much. The trade-off is that it will run on any toaster when lowered enough. I suggest playing a game to see which value works best for you. If you can utilize a dedicated graphics card, then set this value above 60%. For Intel HD graphics users, you might want to lower it even more. Set the view distance to far. Disable shadows and anti-aliasing. Set textures to medium, effects to low, as well as post-processing. Again, for a higher-end PC, you can increase your overall graphics quality settings. Under Advanced Graphics, disable VSync, as it can induce input lag for a low refresh rate monitor. I prefer to disable motion blur, but this will come down to personal preference. Make sure to enable the Show FPS option to troubleshoot performance issues while in-game. The rendering mode should be set to performance to potentially get the highest FPS, but in some cases you will want to use DirectX 11. This will depend on your PC. Make sure to allow multi-threaded rendering. Disable GPU crash debugging, latency markers, Nvidia Reflex Low Latency, Latency Flash, and DLSS, unless you're using an RTX Nvidia graphics card. After applying your changes, you can close Fortnite. Next, right-click your desktop and select Show More Options, and then Nvidia Control Panel. You can do the same step with the AMD driver suit. Here, navigate to Manage 3D Settings and then Program Settings. Select to add a program to customize, and then add Fortnite from the program list. Below, we will change a few settings. Make sure that the CUDA setting is set to your main GPU. Set the Power Management mode to prefer maximum performance, and set the texture filtering quality to performance. You should make sure that your graphics card driver is up to date. I suggest using the GeForce Experience application if you're using an Nvidia GPU, but you can also use the AMD driver suite. In the Drivers tab, simply click on Download and the application will automatically download and install the latest driver. Repeat this step at least a few times a year to make sure that you get the most out of your hardware. In the Home tab, you can access individual game settings, which can also be changed from here. Simply select Details for Fortnite. You will be presented with current in-game settings and with the optimal setting suggestion depending on your hardware. When selecting Optimize, GeForce Experience will apply the recommended settings for the game. You also have the option to use custom settings when selecting this wrench icon. Here, use this slider system to reduce some options and change your display resolution and display mode, in case you're using an abnormal screen resolution as I am. When navigating to your GeForce settings, make sure to disable the in-game overlay in your General Settings tab, as application overlays often cause performance issues. After making sure that your GPU driver is up to date, open up your System Settings window. Here, navigate to the Gaming section. Under Game Mode, you have the option to enable or disable Game Mode on your PC. In theory, Game Mode should prevent Windows Update from performing driver installations and sending restart notifications, as well as help achieve a more stable framerate while in-game. Some users have reported that disabling this option will drastically increase their gaming performance on Windows 11. I suggest disabling this option in case it was enabled before to see if it makes a difference on your PC. In my case, leaving it disabled gets me the highest framerate. In your related settings, select Graphics. Click on Browse to change some custom graphic settings for Fortnite. In your File Explorer, navigate to the drive on which you saved the game on. Program Files, Fortnite, Fortnite Game, Binaries, Win64, and here select the Fortnite Client Win64 Shipping application with the highest file size. This will add Fortnite to this list below. When selecting options for Fortnite, make sure to set the graphics preference to high performance, which, in most cases, will take advantage of your graphics processor to help run the game on your system. Keep your settings window open and search for Update to get to your Windows Update settings. Make sure to check for recent updates, and in case there's an update available to you, make sure to download it before restarting your PC, which will install the update for you. Lastly, I suggest deleting your temporary files, as these can induce lag if your hard drive is cluttered. Search for %temp% and hit enter. This folder contains all of your temporary files, saved by your programs and should be deleted. You can safely delete everything in this folder. Some files might remain, so just leave them there. In case you have any further issues or problems following this tutorial, then I suggest following my extensive guide linked in the description below. I hope this helped you out. Leave a comment if you have any questions, and see you in the next one.